ओके आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द लेक्चर दी व्हाट इज ब्लॉक ब्लॉक बार मोड ऑफ ऑपरेशन इन ब्लॉक बार एल्गोरिथम बेसिक बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक ऑफ फॉर डाटा सिक्योरिटी दैट मीन्स टू इनहेंस द टेक्निक फॉर डाटा सिक्योरिटी वी आर यूजिंग द मोड ऑफ ऑपरेशन फॉर क्रिप्टोग्राफी एल्गोरिथम फॉर इनहेंसिंग द एल्गोरिथम वी आर यूजिंग modes of operations actually there are how many modes of operation there are this type of hello
sir
NIST has recommend 5 modes of operation these modes of operation fit in symmetric block you can see this
page? Hello sir
you can see this page
yes sir
I am saying that
हेलो सर
हाँ टेल मी
सर आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही है सर दो साउंड आ रहा है सर
तो ये कोई म्यूट चल रहा है ना उसकी वजह से
हटा दीजिए सर उसको
हटा दूँ उसे हेलो जो न्यूज चला रहा है बंद कर दो ये नहीं तो मैं हटा दूंगा हाँ नाउ इट्स फाइन ठीक टेक्निक फॉर इनहेंसिंग क्रिप्टोग्राफी एल्गोरिथम वी आर यूजिंग We are using modes of operation, and NIST has recommended 5 modes of operation. These modes are fitted for symmetric block cover, like advanced algorithm also that is being used, like triple DES and AES. And first mode is electronic code book mode (ECB). Electronic code mode, what is happening? There is simplest, this one is simplest mode. And plain text is handling one block at a time. That means it is encrypted one block at a time and key is being used.
Sir, बहुत आवाज कट रहा है।
Key, in this case, key is being used for encrypt, means same key is used for encrypting as well as decrypting. And for encrypting all the blocks, same key is being used. And in this case, message longer than B bits has to be broken into B bits block. Suppose there is block we have to form of B bits. If suppose there is message, lengthy message is there, then we will break that message to fit into B bits block. And suppose after B bits, some more message is remaining, that message will be padded with some values. And decryption also performed using one block at a time, using the same key. That means key is same in the case of encryption as well as decryption. And ECB method, electronic code book method, is used basically used for short messages. It is not good for big messages. Suppose we want to send the key. Suppose we want to transmit DES key or any other key. That message is smaller, and there we can use ECB method, electronic code book method. So for transferring the keys, that means the message which is smaller, we are using ECB mode. But there is some problem in ECB mode. Problem in ECB mode is that if plain text is being repeated, suppose some message in the plain text is being repeated, we are getting same output. That means same keyboard text we are getting by each plain text. That means if repeated plain text is there, suppose I am good boy written 2 times in different block also, but we are using the same key and we are getting the same keyboard text. For that is why that is problem in this. Okay, in this case, what is happening like this? Encryption is done, plain text is being used, key is being used, and that message is B bit plain text is used, and in this case, we get the keyboard text. In the similar way, same key is being used for this block, same key is used for this block. The key is same for all the block and B bits block we have formed, and if any extra block, if extra bits are there that are being padded, and in decryption, key is being used, Kipa text and plain text. For every plain text block, we get a one Kipa text block. So this is the ECB mode, electronic code book mode. Next mode is Kipa block chaining mode. It is Kipa block chaining mode, CBC. This is CBC mode. In Kipa block chaining mode, it overcome the deficiency of ECB mode, electronic code book mode. Dependencies are overcome by Kipa block mode. In this technique, what is happening? If some message is repeated more than one time, then different Kipa text block is produced. Same Kipa text is not produced by that. In this case, what is happening? You can see over here. In this case, there is some initial vector we are applying first on the plain text, and plain text is XORed with initial vector. And this initial vector should be known to sender as well as receiver. This initial vector must be known to sender as well as receiver. And in ECB mode, plain text is XORed first with initial vector, and we get, and it goes to, through the encryption algorithm, and key is used, and we get particular Kipa text block from that. And from next plain text, the whatever we get Kipa text in first block, that is being XORed with plain text of second block. That means second block message will be encrypted by, will be XORed with Kipa text of first block, means previous block. Kipa text of previous block is XORed with plain text of next block. Then encryption key is used, same key is being used, and C2. That means same message, if same block of plain text is being used, we will get different bit of Kipa text. That means same Kipa text we will not get by it. And in when we will perform the decryption, if we will perform the decryption, then in this case, what will happen? I'm going to manage participants. Now all participants. Now, if we are using Kipa text block, then same key is being used, and initial vector is applied on the Kipa text block, and we get the plain text block. That means in next round of block, the Kipa text block of first block is XORed with plain text block. That means whatever we get plain text after decrypting the second block, that is being XORed with Kipa text of first block. Previous block is encrypted by the byte, and we receive the next plain text. In this, it is given initial vector should be known to sender as well as receiver. In this block, I have given such that, suppose in encryption, what is happening? In encryption case, what is applied to encryption? Plain text 2 and Kipa text 1. That is being XORed. The XORed of plain text 2, next block of plain text, and Kipa text previous block. That is being XORed. So that is being XORed. That means CJ minus 1, Kipa text of previous block is XORed with plain text of next block, and K key is being used, and encryption is done, and we receive the encrypted block. That is second encrypted block, Kipa text of first block, XORed with plain text of second block, and K key is being used for the encryption. Same is done over here. You can see Kipa text of first block, XORed with plain text of second block, and encrypted by key K, and we receive the Kipa text of second block. So in this case, for decryption, what we are using? We are using the same key, and whatever we get from the encryption, that is being decrypted like this. In this case, decryption case, the Kipa text of first previous block is XORed with whatever value we get after decrypting, and we receive the plain text of second block. So here what I have done, whatever encrypted value comes over here, key K is being used and that is being decrypted. Similar way we can say that that means encrypted block of previous block is XORed with next block of plain text. That means next block of plain text is XORed with Kipper text of previous block. So in this case, this is done, and this can be written as if we are applying PJ. What is PJ over here? We are getting P, that means CJ minus 1 XORed with DK CJ. So we receive CJ minus 1 XORed with CJ minus 1. That means in this PJ, what is the PJ? PJ is, that means plain text block. And plain text block is this one. Plain text block is this one. So we have XORed with this one, and when these both block will be cancelled, and at last we will get the plain text block. In this case, what is the problem? If opponent is able to fool the receiver, different, if he is providing different value of IV, then if suppose interrupter is there, suppose attacker is there, or crypto analysis is there, then in this case, different value of IV is being produced, initial vector is given, then opponent is able to invert selected bit in first block of plain text. That means if IV is stolen, yeah, different IV is being used by interrupter, then he is able to modify the plain text of first block and Kipper text of first block. So conclusion is that for chaining block mode, it is used appropriate mode for encrypting message of length generated more than B bits. We can achieve confidentiality by using this block. And for authentication purpose, this block can be used. Now, Kipper feedback mode, DES is a block Kipper technique, use B bits block. In data encryption standard, I taught you last class, it used B bits block. DS can be converted into, that means data encryption standard can be converted into stream Kipper. Block Kipper, DES is a block Kipper that can be converted into a stream Kipper either by using Kipper feedback mode or output feedback mode. That can be converted into stream Kipper by using Kipper feedback mode or output feedback mode. Today lecture is of theoretical type. So stream Kipper eliminate need of pad. That means there, if suppose any Kipper from converted it from block Kipper to stream Kipper, then in stream Kipper it is not required how many bits of block is needed. So there will be no padding for that. If any algorithm is converted into stream Kipper, then padding is not needed in that case. So there is no need of padding in this. I can show you this in this case. Initial vector is being used. Shift register is there. Suppose there are S bits. Suppose there are B bits and S bits. That means, what is S bits here? S bits we are getting, that means Kipper text block. The whatever the output from this one, we get Kipper text over here, and Kipper text is chained into next plain text block, and that is set as a, that will be set where it will be played in rightmost block, in rightmost. That means less significant bit it will become. Whatever output will go from here, that will become that will be placed in right hand side and that will become least significant bit. And that is in first case initial vector will be used. In rest of the case, previous Kepler text block will be used for the S bits. And in this case, we will get output of 64 bit block that will be encrypted by key, and we will get output 64 bit block, and we will discard S bits block after we will perform left shift. And in this case, what is happening? We are exclusive or whatever output we are getting from this S block, S bits of output we are getting from this, and that is exclusive or with plain text block 1. And whatever Kepler text block is we are getting, we are feeding in the same next plain text block. And that in next plain text block, this Kepler text block goes in the right side, and that is being placed at the least significant bit. So, and in decryption case, this whatever the output we are getting from here, that is XORed with first block, and we are getting the plain text block from here. The Kepler text block we get from here plus Kepler text block of this one is XORed with plain text block. Kepler text block of this one, and we get plain text. So in that similar fashion, output feedback mode is being used. So next one is output feedback mode. The output feedback mode register in this case, what happened? In that case, what was happening? We was using this one. That means Kepler text block was used to feed in the next plain text mode block. That means actually in next stream plain text mode. That means it was fed from here. Kepler text was fed from here to here. In this case, previous to Kepler text, we are feeding this one from here to here. That means if any change is made in the Kepler text, will not be propagated in the next Kepler text. That means if any change is made in the Kepler text, that will not propagate in the next Kepler text. If any change we are making in the Kepler tag, that will not propagate because input is fed into this is from here, not Kepler tag. That means any changes made in the Kepler tag will not propagate for the next step. So this is only the difference between output feedback mode. This is only the difference between channelback feedback mode and output feedback mode. That means if any error message comes in the Kepler text one, that will be not reflected in next Kepler text. But in chainback feedback mode, if any error come in Kepler text one, that will be reflected into all next blocks in next steps. So this is the advantage of output feedback mode. And in this case, one more is easy. That means checksum portion of message, you can read it. I will put all these notes on the Google Classroom. Now next is counter mode. In counter mode, CTR mode, what is happening? We are using asynchronous transfer mode. That means we are using ATM, bank transfer. In all the case, we are using counter mode. In counter mode, what will happen? That means modulo 2B, that means B means block size. That means there will be subsequent block of 2B. That is B is block size. And in this, we are using the counter, and that counter is encrypted by some key. In this case, we are using counter, and that counter is encrypted by some key, and we get whatever value we get, that is XORed with plain text one, and we get Kepler text one. In this, chaining is not being used. In this case, from where we get the counter, we choose one counter, and that is being incremented in subsequent block. Suppose we are using counter here 5, then the counter will become 6 over here. So in next block, counter is incremented. In this case, in decryption also, the counter is being used. And we encrypt the counter by using K bit. And whatever the ciphertext one we got, we XOR with it and we get final plain text. So these are the modes of operation we are using. What is the advantage of CTR mode? CTR mode, we are getting advantage, hardware advantage, like that means multiple block of plain text or ciphertext. That means it can burn at once. In previous mode, what was happening? Chaining were applied or something was happening. That means first of all, we have to solve the first one. First of all, we have to solve first one. Then only we can solve second one. That means the output of first one was chained to the second one. Input given to the second block. And that chain input, and that chain, because due to that chain in input, parallelism was not achieved. And in this case, parallelism can be achieved because multiple value, because on multiple blocks, it can work at the same time. So these all are advantage of CRT mode. That means it is simple random access. That means any block can be worked at any time. And in parallel also, block can be worked. So today class, I'm going to end. Okay, I'm going to take attendance. So today class is being end, and now I'm going to stop sharing, and I'm going to stop the video.